What is up, guys? Janman here, and we are here today actually with a tutorial, finally. I have been getting a lot of requests for one, and the first one I decided that I wanted to do was lovely, lovely trees. And let me turn my Skype off real quick so we don't get bothered by that in the future. Online status, do not disturb. Alright. There are a couple things about trees that I want to mention. One, they're very important, and so I would advise anyone, actually, not to use the default notch trees. Like, I mean, just look how much better this is than a default tree. Like, default trees are ugly, you know? And another thing, too, is that trees add so much more atmosphere to your plot. You know, one, they can be used so well to dynamically light what you want to be lit. And two, in that practice of using light and shade, it creates a very, very nice atmosphere, just like in real life. Like, imagine you have, like, a forest, for example. Excuse me. And you have areas that, yes, are lit very well, and you have other areas that are very, very shady. And it's that contrast that really creates this kind of, like, oomph of power and atmosphere and kind of almost coziness, especially if you get a lot of trees together and you have, like, big areas of lots of shadiness. And also, too, like, they just look nicer, like I already said. I mean, you know, what a great way to add some more depth to your build than with actual trees that you did not just use bone meal on. So, a couple things today. You'll need, really depending on what kind of tree you want, I'm going to do one similar to this. You're going to want leaves, obviously, and wood, and Voxel and World Edit if you can. Those are actually very, very good, not necessarily for the trunk parts on medium trees, but for the leaf parts. And so I would advise use those. If you can't, then really a quick summary of what you need to do is you really need to get a body of leaves on a trunk that you make, like a nice body of leaves that has not really maybe a nice shape just yet, just something you can work with, and then mold that. Add your branches, whatever you want to add. Expand that out until you get a shape that you're very, very happy with. One of the biggest things I see on trees is that they're either, like, really, really flat leaves because they're done manually, or they're, like, balls of leaves. As you can see, that this does have somewhat of a round quality to it, but it's literally not, it's not literally a ball. You have leaves hanging off. This one's particularly kind of, I don't know, almost a bit willowy, but not quite. I wouldn't really know what I call this tree. And also, too, Word Edit helps you get these lovely, lovely faces that are all wood. So without further ado, I am going to start. Let me first get my wood. I don't know what kind of oak wood should be good, right? And leaves. We're just going to use the typical oak leaves and oak wood. So, oh, I want my arrow, too, for Voxel. Hopefully I will, if you guys do use any of those, I'll be teaching you guys a little bit of Voxel. I need the wand, which should give me, yeah, should give me that. right. So, the first thing we're going to want to do, and I always try to do this manually on the default, not the default trees, the on the medium-sized trees, is you want to get your trunk down. So, let me place a few blocks like this, and really, it's just playing. You know, like, there is really no right or wrong way. Maybe we'll have, like, a little root there, maybe a little root there. Maybe this one comes up, goes, excuse me, maybe goes that way. Let's bring the tree up a little bit more, a couple blocks up here. And this is one of the things where you don't want extreme curviness at first. You want, not curviness, I should say, verticalness, like this going straight up. You don't really want that too much. You want a nice gradual kind of change in slope. You see, you start smaller and get bigger as you go up. So that is how that works. Let me, I don't know how big is that tree? That's a decent amount of blocks high, right? Alright, so, I'm going to get this going, and then I'm going to start kind of going up with my limbs, is what I wanted to say. Okay, so it starts like that. Well, we'll fix these blocks later. I know they're a little bit messy right now, but you kind of want them all going the same way. Start going up like that. Let's do a little bit of that. Maybe even, did I like that? That's not too bad. It's a little bit steppy, but I think for our purposes, it'll work. That's a decent trunk. So what you want to do now is just keep going up a little bit. I'm gonna go up a little bit further, even, and just keep these nice curves going. Make it consistent all the way through. All the way through. So like right here is what I was talking about. It's a little bit steppy, and I don't know if I quite like that, but for what we're doing, it should be okay. I feel like I want to add something here, you know? Okay. I'll make these too steppy. Okay, that's decent. That's a decent size. Bring these down a little bit, maybe. And start our branches here. Alright, so these you want to start doing at this point, and really, actually let me go up a little bit higher, just so we have some more of that there. Alright, so these are really important. These are the branches, and although that, when you're using, like, Voxel basically just, like, clears right out of these, so you kind of use these as, like, a nice, what I want to say, structure, so that you have an idea of where you're going. These aren't going to be... There's like placeholder branches, is what I want to say. Placeholder, yeah. Let me do that. That looks decent. So, these are going to be placeholders. So when you're using Voxel, you're basically just going to have these as places to point your mouse and click when you have leaf blobs, and I'll show you guys that in a second. And then what you want to do afterwards is you'll come back and you'll go, okay, what can I add now? Like I want to redo my limbs, because basically they kind of go away as you put the leaf blobs down. That, I don't know if I quite like, it's a little bit too similar. I don't like that. Yeah. Maybe do that on the end. Even that. That's not too bad. Alright. And then extend this out a little bit more. That's not too bad. Okay. Alright. So we have a good structure going. And now, this is where the good part comes. This is kind of the playing part with the leaves. So what you're going to do, first you want to get your brush down. And this is going to be /B/blob is what you're going to put in there. Now you can see all this other stuff come up. Brush size, I believe that's with B. /B, we want to do, for the blobs, you want a pretty, pretty decent size. I'm going to go, let's try 11. Actually, let me see. Ugh. Oh, right. Oops, I got the wrong material. That's what we need to do first. Material. So you do /V/, and then your material. In this case, if we are, of course, using leaves. I say that's decent, right? /U, undo that. Let's try this real quick. I felt like we could even go bigger. What if we do 15? Let's start with 15 and see where it takes us. Okay, so 15 is a pretty decent size. Ooh, that's went a little bit too low. And so really, it's just getting a feel for this, doing it, again, too low, don't like that. Just keep playing with it until you get something you're like, ugh, do what I want, come on. There you go, that's better. Let me even reduce the size a little bit, so 13. So like I said, it is really just playing until you get something that you are positively happy with. So let's get these. You can see these are exactly what I was talking about. These are kind of the foundation. I'm using these to click and guide myself where I want these leaves to go. You don't want things to be too off balance. You don't want it to look like they're literally like lines of leaves coming off. So that's where kind of balancing it comes in. You might even want to add a little bit. Well, I don't know if I added too much there. But add a little bit onto the ends. Like right there, I might add some. And you might go down to a smaller brush size. Let's try 10, just one smaller. And now you want to really fill this tree out. So we want to make it so that we have those branches, right? We also just want to fill it out and make sure that it's kind of breadthy. Because trees are pretty breadthy. You know, they come up, they spring out, and they have this huge kind of like canopy of leaves. And it is very, very atmospheric, very, very beautiful. So let's keep adding more of these. Sorry about the chat, by the way. There's so many people on the server. It can be kind of overwhelming at times. Okay, so we're getting some decent so far. Let's balance these out over here. So I talk about on the sides where you have, like, it goes in and then you have the lines. But now you can see it is just kind of coming full circle. You can extend these out even a little bit more if you wanted to. Alright, oh, maybe not that much. Let's see. Okay, good. We can see it's kind of flat over here, so I'm going to extend it out over here too, even though we didn't have a branch. And I can add the branch in afterwards. Okay. That's pretty decent, I feel like. So now is where it comes in. You just kind of want to go around and actually manually kind of just fix things and tweak things until you get something that you are happy with. So, like, this kind of blocky right there. I don't always want, like, things to be, like, sticking out. Really what you want to do at this point is kind of avoid very square or rectangular shapes. Like that, that looks really unnatural. But if I did something like that, then that is a lot less unnatural. It looks a lot more natural. It's a lot more organic is what we usually call that. What I want to do here, I just want to fill up some of these holes and actually even maybe make some holes. I kind of like something that I've been experimenting with is kind of like keeping some of the leaves like almost as if they're floating. I kind of like that idea. So let's try that. It's all about experimenting, really, is like my main point. If you want to take something away from this, is that experiment, you know, like just go with what feels good, even what doesn't feel good, and just see how it turns out. And then if that point you're like, I don't really like that, then change it, you know? That's all it's about, is playing and finding what really looks good to you, and obviously to other people, but, you know, generally those things kind of are one and the same for the most part. I do like the kind of holiness it has here. See, it's not totally flat. You have all these little peaks and all these little valleys in the tree. That is one of the things I like the most, and I do like, I kind of like this flatness that we have here. You can see on this tree, I tried to do where it gradually comes up. You can see it goes up and up and up to this kind of point where it's at its highest. But here, it's kind of flat, and I'm not sure if I like that or not. I think I do. I think I'm gonna keep that. But just keep going around, keep playing. Like here, oh, that's really rectangular. Let's see if we can fix that. There we go. That's better. Like this, that's rectangular as well. That's kind of rectangular. That's kind of rectangular. What else is rectangles here? This is a little bit too linear. Let's add some more onto that. Let's add some more of these floating leaves. I like... Come on. Like that. That's cool. Or even like, yeah, let's do one up here. Ah. Maybe it's a little too far. Alright. This is a bit rectangular as well. Let's have that float. Let's have that float. Let's have that float. Lots of floaties. Floaty floats. So, I'm not gonna do this all the way to what I consider perfection, just because that does take a lot of time. Honestly, actually the second plot that I did, to get into Visionary, which is the build team, I did totally by hand, and the leaves literally took forever. So I'm going to move on to the next part, which is kind of thickening out the trunk. You see, it gets very, very thin here, and it's kind of not proportional to the tree itself. So we're going to go back up to the top here, and we're going to add some things to kind of thicken it out near the top. Let's see. Look at that. Do that a little bit. Maybe even bring that down, actually. That's not too bad. Maybe pull that down one more. Pull this down a little bit. Okay. That's not too bad. It could be better, but... Oh, let me fix this. That's really... ugh. I don't like that. There. Let's bring that up. Let's bring that. Okay, awesome. Let's even put one like right there. Yeah. Okay. I think that's pretty good. Yeah? That's not too bad. I may even want to thicken it like right there. And like right there as well. There. I like that. It's not as good as this one, but it's still pretty decent. So the last thing you want to do is pretty simple. You just want to add your what do they call these? Stems? Branches. That's right. You want to add your branches back. I kind of like, this is kind of just stylistically, I like my branches to be very, very visible. I like them to kind of stick out and create, again, that depthy feel. So maybe that one gets hidden. This one comes right up here. Maybe that one gets kind of hidden by the leaves as well. Maybe thicken that up a bit. This one doesn't quite so hidden. It comes out of it and even gets a little bit thick. I should go there. Yeah, I like that. I like that. That's good. Let me hide this. Peek-a-boo. Okay. Oh, let me add a little bit onto that. I feel like that's not quite as thick as it should be. You know? Alright. I would say that is pretty decent. It could be a bit better. I kind of feel as though it's a little bit unbalanced on that side, so maybe even extend this a little bit more if you wanted to. Ooh, careful. Might be a little bit too much. Alright, that's not too bad. So yeah, just playing with it until you get what feels good, and eventually, you know, it looks pretty darn good. Not perfect, but it is as close as we need to be for the purposes of this tutorial. I'm going to do one more thing, so wand. It'll give you your lovely world edit brush, the axe, kind of. And I'm going to do // position 1 for right there. And this will create a position at exactly where I am at. So that one will create one right where I was standing right there. And you want to change all the wood. I think wood is 17. So replace the ID. So replace 17 with... I forget what the ID for, it's like a metadata, it's like fully covered blocks, so we're going to play with this until we get one that's right. Oh, on the first try, I made it. I think these are spruce, actually, now. Yes, they are. Okay, well, let's try 14. Nope. These are, again, the metadata is for the completely covered kind of log wood things, you know, on all faces, you know. The only thing I do like to change is I like kind of the contrast of having the branches have those little faces. But again, that is just a personal preference thing. I don't really care if you do it or if you don't. I really doubt anybody else is going to care, and they're sort of like super anal about it. Don't laugh at that. Anal. But yes, overall, pretty good. So if you like this tutorial, feel free to try it out for yourself. This is for you. It's a lot about playing and kind of getting what you like the best and what you like the most, what you think looks best. Feel free to like, comment, and subscribe. I really hope you felt this was helpful. And if there's something that you are confused about, feel free to put it in the comments. I'm always reading the comments and trying to answer them. So if there's something you're not quite sure about, then, you know, just ask. It's fine. I'll get to it. Maybe not immediately, but I will definitely get to it. So again, hope you enjoyed the tutorial, and I will see you guys next time on the other side. See ya.